Okay, we're here at Grasby. Steve Robson. People do want to know why you've not been to the top of Helm Crag. No, we need answers. We do need to know why you've never been to the top. Why have you been so flimsy?
Because I've always been with people that have been happy just to come down without doing it.
That's a weak and feeble excuse.
Yeah, so today is the day.
That's pathetic, really. You're going to do it today?
It could be the day.
You are going to go up today?
Or I might do a seat sandal.
You're definitely going to go up Helm Crag today.
You're telling me I'm going to do it today?
Yes.
Right. It will be done.
Promise.
I hope so.
That's a yes.
Yes, could be. Very likely.
Definitely.
Probably. More than probably.
This is a microphone, allegedly. Where are you going?
Over there.
No, where are you going?
Up there. Oh, up there, yes, up there. Up by Jackdaw Crag and White Crag, I think it's called.
You only went up a year ago.
I can't remember. It's a bit sketchy in my memory because I had other plans at that point to climb the Howitzer. That was paramount to me at that point.
You're lying.
But I didn't manage. So here we are again, nearly a year later.
It's pathetic, really, isn't it?
This could be the big one.
What's that there?
A boulder.
It's pointing
that out. Where's it come from? Where's it come from? Has it rolled down the slope?
Boulder.
Has it arrived up through the earth?
Bunker.
Having a grand time. What could possibly go wrong?
You could fall off the top. You're going to the top, because you haven't been to the top, have you?
I haven't committed myself yet.
You did?
Julian's always saying I should be committed.
You promised. Because you're not a man of the mountains till you've actually been to the very top.
Well, I either will or I won't. More I cannot say.
You can't keep telling people you're the man of the mountains.
People keep telling me I'm the man of the mountains. But I do reinforce it when I recognise views, don't I? I am the man of the mountains. It's just that I'm very quiet. And I'm saying it's a bit like in Dead Man Walking, when you're walking along beside all the cells and everybody's rattling their cages and you've got your slippers on and your foot cuffs and your handcuffs and you're all primed, you've had your legs shaved, you know, it's all over, you've had the last supper, there's a priest there, there's your nursey friend that used to be in Thelma and Louise, and just that feeling of time running out, evaporating. Yes. Really lovely to be up here with two of my best fell walking mates. I have many fell walking mates actually, but they tend to come and go, some of them. These two tend to be keepers for some reason. I like warts, I can't quite get rid of them. And they can't quite get rid of me either, by the same token. But it's one of those beautiful evenings, marvellous vistas, sun shining on Grasmere, as the weather forecast predicted.
As you say, as the Lars would say, and he is a bit of a la-la, isn't he? We up there, swifts, swallows, la 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 la, heads in the clouds, dreaming his man of the mountains. That's easy. See if you can get up there. Get up on top.
The wrong one. No, that's the wrong one. That's the erection. That one.
Side. lost your foot already. That's all that's left of Steve. That's all that's left of him. That brave man that we once knew is now just all poppy soul.
Bye bye, brave Steve.
Erection known as the Howitzer, the Lion and the Lamb. This is the part where you've never been, the very summit, of the mountaintop. We call the Mount of the Mountains. Hitherto you've been carrying that nom de plume, probably, shouldn't really be carrying it actually, should you? So to carry it, you need to go up there now. How do you feel?
It's very windy. And just getting back to the last supper sort of thing.
What would you have for your last supper?
I don't know, because I haven't had one yet.
What would you have, Julian?
Mustard and cheese. Steak fried chips, lauder?
Yeah,
you're not speaking, obviously. Yeah. But I wonder how they managed to eat anything if they're about to die.
Well, shall we find out?
I'll have my sandwiches afterwards.
Come on then. Frankly, Steve, that was pathetic, really, wasn't it?
No. I don't feel bad about it. I mean, the other two are giving me a little bit of a jibe, unfortunately, but no.
Even unfortunately, it's unfortunate about it.
Well,
you didn't do it.
I just
you
feel,
promised.
I feel
you
that it was,
swore.
It was beyond me.
You were going to do it.
It was a bridge too far. It was the angle up. It was the high wind that was blowing. It was the fact that I chickened out.
But you're bigger than.
Yes, true, and you've done so well, both of you, and I do admire you, but no, not to me. I just cannot do it, and then I'll have to go through the rest of my life knowing that I can't do it.
You're going to apologise.
It's unattainable.
You're going to apologise, you're going to say sorry.
Unattainable.
You're going to say sorry.
Sorry, camera.
No, to all those
sorry, microphone.
There, you've been deluding all these years.
Well,
hello, Lakeland Walker. Can you
there's
back to all those articles he's written for you?
There's a lot of garlic in what you've eaten tonight, isn't that, Nick? Am I right in thinking? It's nearly knocking me over here.
That's changing the subject, isn't it?
That was a bit of a swerve. Sorry. Yes. I'll wholeheartedly apologise. But that said, I don't feel too badly.
Did you get paid for that last month?
No.
That's a good thing, because that would ask to give you money back.
Not a bean. No, I don't. I always do my journal, so there'll be a little piece in the journal.
Just won't be very long, will it?
Just explaining that no, sometimes you've just got to, discretion is the better part of valour, you've just got to pull back, you know, and